ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम
ओम
नमो
नमो
भगवते
भगवते
वासुदेवाय।
वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो
नमो
भगवते
भगवते
वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
तस्मादेकेन मनसा
तस्मादेकेन
तस्मादेकेन
मनसा
मनसा भगवान सात्वतां पति
भगवान सात्वतां
भगवान
पति
श्रोतव्या
श्रोतव्या
कीर्तितव्यश्च
कीर्तितव्यश्च
ध्येयपूज्यश्च नित्यदा
ध्येयपूज्यश्च नित्यदा।
And you would like to volunteer to read the translation and purport?
I can read the translation, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Yes, please.
Hare Krishna. Therefore, with one pointed attention. Sorry, Prabhuji. Wait for a minute, I'll go inside. Therefore, one pointed attention, one should constantly hear about, glorify, remember, and worship the personality of Godhead, who is the protector of devotees. Hare Krishna. Am I audible, Prabhuji?
Yes, Madhavi. Madhavi, you want to read the purport as well?
I can
Yes.
try, Prabhuji. If realization of the absolute truth is the ultimate aim of life, it must be carried out by all means. In any one of the above mentioned castes and orders of life, the four processes, namely glorifying, hearing, remembering, and worshipping, are general occupations. Without these principles of life, no one can exist. Activities of the living being involve engagements in these four different principles of life. Especially in modern society, all activities are more or less dependent on hearing and glorifying. Any man from any social status becomes a well-known man in human society within a very short time if he is simply glorified truly or falsely in the daily newspapers. Sometimes political leaders of a particular party are also advertised by newspaper propaganda, and by such a method of glorification, an insignificant man becomes an important man within more time. But such propaganda by false glorification of an unqualified person cannot bring any about any good, either for the particular man or for the society. There may be some temporary reactions to such propaganda, but there are no permanent effects. Therefore, such activities are a waste of time. The actual object of glorification is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has created everything manifested before us. We have broadly discussed about this fact. Sorry, we have broadly discussed this fact from the beginning of the Janmadyasya shloka of the Bhagavatam. The tendency to glorify others or hear others must be turned to the real object of glorification, the Supreme Being, and that will bring happiness. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, was I audible?
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Okay, Mataji. Okay.
Do you want to explain something, Mataji?
Mataji, in this song, I could understand that Prabhupada is saying that how important the hearing and glorification is in life. That, you know, sometime in newspaper, if falsely or truly we, you know, we hear or we read about people's glorification, and then, you know, you remember it, and then that person becomes famous in no time, you know. So here Prabhupada is saying the truly glorification or hearing should be only about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but no other person, but only Supreme Personality of Godhead, because that is the only thing which will bring happiness in your life. And, you know, and in the Srimad Bhagavatam, this Janmadi Asya, the first shloka of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada has explained about, you know, he started with this. I don't remember the exact translation, but I think here it's about glorification of Krishna, how he created, you know, how important he is, how, you know, important he is for everybody, you know, in our life, because he's the one who created the world. And so glorification of Krishna and hearing more about Krishna can bring the happiness in our life. That's all I could understand, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for explaining, Mataji. Anybody else wants to share? If not, then I think we can move on, and then whenever Prabhuji comes, he can share something.
Yeah, Mataji, this shloka of Janmadi Asya, actually I'm reading the translation, and in here it's all about Sri Krishna's glorification here. So that's why this shloka has been mentioned in this purport. Yeah, I'm just reading it. Hare Krishna. Do you want me to read that, Mataji, once, or Abhi can go ahead?
Yes, Mataji, you can read it.
Okay, I'll read it. So translation is, O my Lord Sri Krishna, son of Vasudeva, O all-pervading personality of Godhead, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. I meditate upon Lord Sri Krishna because he is the absolute truth and the primeval cause of all causes of the creation, sustenances and destruction of the manifested universes. He is directly and indirectly conscious of all manifestation, and he is independent because there is no other cause beyond him. It is he who first imparted the Vedic knowledge unto the heart of Brahmaji, the original living being. By him, even the great sages and demigods are placed into illusion. As one is bewildered by the illusory as a representation of water seen in fire or land seen on water, only because of him do the material universes temporarily manifested by the reactions of the three modes of nature appear factual, although they are unreal. I therefore meditate upon him, Lord Sri Krishna, who is eternally existent in the transcendental abode, which is forever free from the illusory representation of the material world. I meditate upon him for he is the absolute truth. So he has explained very nicely here in the purport, you know, and glorifying Sri Krishna. Hare Krishna, Mataji.